It's time to settle an epic office debate. Should you listen to music while you work? Look, this seems like a simple question, right? Does music help you be more productive or not? But think about how many different types of music there are, and then think about how many different types of work there are, and then think about how many different types of personalities there are. Now, sure, there's a thing called the Mozart effect that researchers have found that says listening to Mozart sonatas before a mental activity can spark stronger spatial reasoning.
And doesn't actually make you smarter, by the way, which is what everyone says.
Right, but that's one very specific thing. And what about Mozart sonatas during a task? Or what about death metal? So for a study published last month in the Journal of Experimental Psychology Applied, researchers recruited 142 undergraduate students to perform simple and complex tasks, basically data entry versus memorization. They either did this in silence or with a soundtrack of simple or complex instrumental music. The music tracks used the same piano, strings, and synth elements, but the complex tracks added in drums and bass. The participants also took personality tests beforehand to tell the researchers a bit more about their work styles. And the results? Maybe not what you would expect. So some of the participants had said they prefer external stimulation. These are the kinds of people who check their phones while watching TV. And those participants were less able to handle working to music. They were the ones who wanted to listen to music the most, but ironically, they performed best on the complex tasks when they worked in silence. And get this, their peers who did not have a preference for external stimulation performed best when music played. For the simple tasks, the external stimulation seekers performed best to no music or simple music, while their peers who got bored less easily performed best to complex music. Okay, so what does this mean? Well, the results suggest that people who like external stimulation have a huge amount of attention they can give to the world. That attention splits easily when they're doing multiple things, like doing work and listening to music. But when they're doing a single isolated task, they can get very deeply absorbed, which is why they do better when there's no music or just simple music playing. Meanwhile, people on the other end of the spectrum actually benefited from the distraction because it was just enough to keep their minds from wandering. Across the board, people can only enjoy so much distraction. Music might help you do a simpler task better to a degree, but there's a tipping point where that music will overload you even when you're doing a simple task. And that overload might happen earlier if you're the type of person who likes a lot of external stimulation, because you're actively seeking that sensation. So again, if you like a ton of stimulation, maybe music is good for you, but you want to keep it really simple because then you won't be overstimulated and distracted by it.